Good morning, dear students. This is Dr. Savita Tidme. I welcome you all in our next lecture of the subject Animal Ecology, under which chapter number 3, Population, and the topic Growth. So, in our previous lecture, that is, we have already spent 5 lectures on this topic for studying the concept of population as well as characteristics of population, right? So, number of characteristics of population like natality, mortality, even the fecundity, dispersal, dispersion, like that. Number of characteristics we have already studied in our previous lecture. Now, in the present lecture, we will be studying the population growth, how the population grows, and it is expressed in terms of curves, that is exponential growth curve. Okay, as well as logistic growth curve. In the present lecture, we will be studying the exponential growth of an population. Okay. Now, dear students, in our last lecture, what we have studied? Population dynamics, that means a growth of a population in terms of two ways, two growth curves, exponential and logistic. Three models we already studied in our last lecture. Now let's see what is there in today's growth lecture. Right, see, the growth is bouncing, right? So whatever is the population, that is always changing. A population is a changing entity. It's not going to be a constant. Say, like this, a single man. For a number of years, this single man will remain a single, or this population of three people remain same? No, it is going to change. So it is a ever-changing entity, right? It is ever-changing entity. So its a size and composition are ever changing, not remain going to be constant. So changes in the size and composition are depend on what, right? So size of the population is small here. It is little big at this point, and it is bigger as compared to the previous points, right? So this composition of the growth is depend on what? It must be depend on some factors, right? Yes or no? Yes, it must be depend on some factors, means a characteristic of that population. Which are they? Which are the factors or characteristic? Yes, birth rate, that means a natality. What is the birth rate in the population that going to influence the population growth, right? If the birth rate is very low, then the population will grow slowly. And if the birth rate is more, means fast, so the population will grow rapidly. Correct, very good. Now, this birth rate is also going to influence the population, death rates, that means a mortality, and even the movement, that is immigration of the population or organism, also find its way in the population as well as from the population. So that suddenly shows effect on the population growth, right? Even the unlimited environment and its influence on the population is also been important. Now, in the beginning, the number of animal in first age category would increase by birth, right? When the population reproduces, or when individual reproduces, the number of young ones, they increases in number. First of all, how the population is going to increase from this to this, how the population increases from this to this, how it is increases. So when they reproduces, what the number of, first of all, the number of young individuals in a population, it increases, right? And the young one will later on become adult, and they again reproduce to give rise to the young ones, right? So the growth of population is again means it is influenced by the age, or it is first calculated by the age category, age groups, and it is increases by birth. While those of the older age groups would remain stationary, because older people, their life or their reproductive phase is already passed. So they remain stationary. They are not going to increase anymore. Means their number is not going to multiply anymore, but whatever young ones are there, okay. So suppose consider as these people, they have already give rise to them. Means they have, these are the offspring of them, right? So after their post reproductive phase, are they going to multiply or are they going to reproduce to give rise to the young ones? No. So their number remains stationary, their number remains steady, older people, right? But the younger one, they become adult and they give rise to the offspring, they produce offspring. So number of offspring is again going to be increased, right? So as time goes on, the age categories increases as a survivor of the initial age groups grow side by side. So as more animal enter into the initial as more animals enter into the reproductive stage, greater number of young ones are produced. Obviously, if two animals are there, that will going to give rise to the limited. See here, three individuals, just consider this is an example. So consider these two are in the reproductive stage, and if they reproduce, they can reproduce this much individual. And consider these all are in the reproductive stage, they can reproduce to a large number of individual, right? What it means, the number of individual are in the reproductive stage going to give rise to large number of individual, large number of young ones. That means the number of reproductive individual is important for the growth of any population. Right, evenly after several generations, eventually after several generations, the population will grow at fairly steady rate, right? And if the number of animal is plotted against the time, the point will fall into an exponential increase curve. And if the logarithm of the number of animal are plotted against the time, the point will fall in the straight line curve. So the growth curve or growth of a population is further classified, or it is further distributed, categorized in two main growth curves, two main forms. The J-shaped growth curve, that is called as a exponential growth curve, right? J-shaped growth curve is called as an exponential growth curve, and S-shaped growth curve is called, also called as a logistic growth curve or the sigmoidal growth curve. Remember these two points, okay? J-shaped growth curve, it may ask in the examination, yes. J-shaped growth curve, exponential growth curve, S-shaped logistic growth curve. Now let's move ahead and see what are the exponential growth curve, what are the sigmoidal or logistic growth curve. Now, exponential growth curve, it is also called as unlimited population growth. It is also called as unlimited population growth. Now, what that unlimited population growth means? So, all the populations have the capacity for increase in size. Obviously, every population, means a population of plant or population of animals, cattle, you can say the elephant, human, Drosophila, means every population has a capacity for increase in size, right? And how they increase in size? By increasing in number. But the unlimited population increase not occur for continuously for any species. Unlimitedly, they are not going to multiply. There is some limitation for the population growth, right? And exponential growth explains the population growth increase in ideal environment and also express the capacity of a species to increase the population, right? What the exponential growth means? The increase of the population in an ideal environment, right, as well as the capacity of a species to increase the population, how long the population can be increased in an ideal environment, that is nothing but the exponential growth, right? Even it occurs when the member of a population reproduce at a steady rate, right? Just like, yes. For example, a population increased in a size per unit time as per the manner, like one individual reproduces to two. See, this is example of the lower organism like protozoan. One reproduces to two, two to four, four to eight, 8 to 16, to 13, to etc. Then the population is displaying the exponential growth, and each time, each unit time, the population is increasing by the factor 2, right? At every stage, if you see, the population is increasing by the factor 2. So, this exponential growth means the population size at a given time is equal to the population size at the earlier time, and which is always more than, or it is always greater than the previous one. Means today's population is always greater than the earlier time's population. See, this example is again I'm citing the same example which we have studied in few lectures back, right? The today's population of India, human population of India is 130 crore near about. And if you go 20 years back, it was like near about 30 crore. Just an example. It is not the actual value, but just an example. Near about this, the values was there. So, if you compare today's population with the 20 years back's population, which one is more? Which one is greater? Yes, present time population, that is today's population, is always greater, 100 times greater than the population before 20 or 30 years. So the population in which the growth is like 1 to 2 to 2, 4. So it is said to be the exponential population or exponential growth. And when the population size is graphed against the time generation, exponential growth is being observed. So the exponential growth curve is also called as a J-shaped growth curve. Let's see some of the equations which are plotted for explaining the exponential growth in case of a population. So what is the equation? Equation is here n small t equals to n0 in bracket 2t. Here what is the n? N is the number, and 0 is what? Again generation. This underscript indicate the generation, right? So n is the number, and if it is multiplied by 1, so first generation. Here is the 0 I have written, means a 0 generation. This is just a standard formula, right? And thus the number is number in the third generation will be, what will be the number in the next generation? See, yes, n 3 equals to 1 in bracket 2 3 equals to 8, means what? The number of individual, whatever is the number of individuals, say it is a 1, okay? And the what is the generation? It is a third generation we are counting. And here, as the number of individual is considered to be 1 initially as the number of individual was 1. So here what is the generation, number of generation? It is a third generation we are counting from that single individual, right? So this 1 is multiplied by what? 2. So what is 2 in this case? A single generation if it is multiplied by 2. What it means? Yes, this means each time the population is increasing by the factor 2. This is the factor. Here you can see 1 to 2, 2 to 4, 4 to 8. So it is multiplied by 2. Now that is given here, right? Multiplication factor is there. So first means a single number of individual, if there are three generations and at every time the generation, each generation is multiplied by 2. So what is the number? It comes 8. So if a single individual is there in the first generation, in the third generation there will be 8 number of individuals produced from that single one. So this equation is for the population that doubtless in each, that doubles in each generation. So more generation will be having more number of population. So for the more generations, this formula is given, that is nt equals to n0 in bracket ert. And what is that n0 and ert? Let's see. Just a second. Yes, that n0 and ert is nothing but the natural increase. R is said to be the natural increase. This small r is said to be the natural increase. And increase to calculate if natality and mortality rates are known to you. Right. And this r is said to be the natality rate minus the mortality rate per year. Okay. And this the rt is nothing, r is nothing but the exponential growth constant. Okay, this er is said to be the exponential growth constant, which is nothing but 2.718, and this r is again constant. Okay, exponential growth constant. And n is obviously number, t is nothing but the time scale, or you can say generation. Okay, and rest of the things which are same here, but only this one is exponential growth rate constant at a particular generation. Okay, now the logistic equation. Let's see what is the logistic equation. Yes, there is dn divided by dt equals to r0n in bracket k minus n divided by k. What are these symbol, which what symbolize it? Where r0 is innate capacity of the population to increase. It is the inborn capacity of a population to increase without a resource limitation. Naturally, how this population or how any population can reproduce, that is nothing but the r0. Okay. So, natural reproductive capacity of a population is r0. N, population size, means a population number. And this k is the highest population density. Okay. That can be maintained in a real environment. Okay, highest population density that can be maintained in a real environment. Okay, so this formula is used for calculating the growth, that is logistic equation. Now, actually this logistic equation should be after, but no problem, we have studied it earlier. So, in case of the exponential growth curve, how the exponential growth curve appears, let's see. Okay, so this J-shaped, why it is called as a J-shape? Now, you can say this is nothing but like a bell shape. No, you cannot, because this is what? Broken. It is broken, declining curve it is. So, we have to consider this curve, or it is considered from this point. So, it appears like a J shape. It appears like a J shape. This is the population density, and here there is time of, means you can say generations, first generation, second generation, third generation, fourth generation, or up to a particular time it has been increased. So this type of growth curve involves a geometric ratio of increase up to a certain point, right? It increases population, increases up to a certain point, and then there is an abrupt decline in the growth rate. So, this growth rate after a certain point, it found to be declining. So, this decline is due to the factors of environmental resistance. So, any population that cannot grow beyond a limit, it has to stop at particular point. It can grow initially, grow further, and it is growing exponentially with the highest limit, highest speed. It grows. But up to a certain point, after that, the environmental factors, they resist the growth of such a population, and then the population start decline, right? Maybe the resources, they are not sufficient. Maybe the resources means you can say biotic resources, they are not sufficient to fulfill the requirement of a growing population. So after that, the population start decline, right? So this kind of a curve in which initial there is exponential growth, after that there is a declining stage. So this is said to be the J-shaped curve. And this J-shaped pattern of the population is characterized by what? It is characterized by the density of a population increases rapidly. The number, density is what? Nothing but a number. Number of an individual increases very rapidly in compound interest fashion, right? 2 multiplied by 2 become 4, in 4 multiplied by 2 again 8 by multiplied by 2 become 16. So it is increasing in a compound interest fashion or in the exponential fashion, then stops abruptly on the environmental resistance. Environment is going to resist such a growth, and other limiting factors are become effective in controlling the growth of such a population. And these factors may be food. Food is not available, become limiting factor for such a population at one stage, right? Even the space which is occupied by this organism is again become a limiting factor for them. Even the seasonal factors like forest or as well as excessive rain again becomes a limiting factor. The termination of the reproductive season is again important case in regulating the density of such a population or growth of such a population. So in this pattern of a growth, the density reaches the upper limit, remains at that level for time, for a particular time, means what? This density, when it reaches to the upper limit, it will remain at this point for the particular time. Say you can look here, for one or two generation it will remain at the highest peak, right? For one or two generations. See, this is we considered as just a consideration. This is a timeline scale, but timeline scale is again coordinated with the generation. So consider here first generation, second generation, third generation, fourth, fifth, sixth, like that. Okay, so the highest peak of the population remain constant for a particular timeline, for a particular time scale, that is generation, for the specific generation, and then it start decline. So this type of growth pattern can be seen in early algal blooms, right? You might have seen in any one of the water body, the algae, they start growing exponentially within very limited time or short time. The entire lake has been occupied by the algal blooms, right? But later on, you can find that the algae, they are dying, right? So that is what? Decline in the population, right? Even annual plants, even lemmings of the tundra, in case of the tundra, there is again a grassland ecosystem, and in which such a type of things they are observed, such a type of growth curve is observed. Even in case of a mammals like in deer, such a kind of peak is there. So this is the type of the growth curve is not very common, but certain organisms, they used to show this J type of growth curve. Even it is very well studied in case of a protozoan. So what is this? Yes. What is this? What is the animal? Yes, it is a protozoan animal, especially amoeba. How it multiplies? A single amoeba that multiply by binary fission. One is divided into two, and from the one it going to form two amoeba. Again, these two, each of which going to form the another two. Means from the single two amoeba they form. After these two, two to four. And from the 4 to again 8, like that. Here is again one of the example. This is another protozoan saying, yes, I am also there. So what? It also reproduced by the longitudinal binary fission. A single euglena going to give rise to two daughter euglena. And when each of them become mature, they also going to give rise another two daughter euglena each. Right. So what it means, again here is the growth is exponential. Well, from single it produces 2, from 2 to 4, 4 to 8, 8 to 16, like that. Even the paramecium, one's favorite paramecium, is again not lagging behind. It is also in the same race of exponential growth. Right. Now these three examples we have studied for the exponential growth.